Scientists at the Wu Tsai Neurosciences Institute at Stanford University have created an improved method to let people with paralysis communicate freely and rapidly by translating brain activity to text. As part of an ongoing clinical trial, they implanted recording electrodes into the motor cortex of a man with severe paralysis and eavesdropped on the neural patterns produced as he imagined writing words by hand.
And we can decode that so that we can predict with 95% accuracy which character you want to type, and we're able to do so quite rapidly at about 90 characters per minute. It's about the same rate that a person in that same age bracket, early 60s, can type on a smartphone.
The Stanford team previously developed a brain-computer interface that let paralyzed study participants type at 40 characters per minute by using brain activity to select letters from a virtual keyboard. But decoding brain activity produced by imagined handwriting turns out to be much more precise.
And that's because when you write a letter, it's rather a complicated shape, as opposed to a straight line movement like you might make with your arm or another system that just moves a cursor. And we can decode that over twice the speed of a regular point and click BCI. A final very important point of this work is that it is a so-called open vocabulary or open dictionary. Because we're writing individual letters, you can spell any word in the English language. And therefore, if you need, as most people do, at least several thousand words to make it through an average day, we can do that. This really addresses participants' number one request, which is independence. We really want to have systems work well enough that they can actually provide some real benefit.
I'm excited about the possibilities. I think this will, at some point, become a real clinically useful tool in our armamentarium to help people with paralysis.
So we have a very close relationship with our participants, and their dedication inspires us. We derive inspiration, reminders of why we do what we do.